You know, the concept is we think of diabetic retinopathy as a progressive retinal non-perfusion process, right? Unfortunately, we've all seen these eyes in clinic where they have loss of vascularity over time due to the diabetic retinopathy progression. And there's this lingering question in the field, can our pharmaceutical agents impact that process? Can they slow it down? Can they reverse it? Can you get reperfusion? What can happen to the vascular bed, right? We know you can change the number of intraretinal hemorrhages with injections, but what's happening more fundamentally? That was sort of the question. And the history behind this is actually really important. If you look back all the way to the 1960s, actually, there's multiple published reports showing that reperfusion of non-perfused retina in diabetes, in patients with diabetes and diabetic retinopathy can happen. Across multiple authors, multiple continents, there's excellent papers showing this can happen well before the anti-VEGF pharmaceutical era. And most recently, people like Richard Rosen have published beautiful work using adaptive optics, SLO, showing that there's sort of a dynamic state where sometimes vessels may appear to be perfused and sometimes they may appear to be non-perfused. And so we still have a lot to learn about this field. But in the modern era, in the anti-VEGF era, we have data from both RIDE and RISE and VISTA showing that if you treat these eyes with DME and diabetic retinopathy and non-perfusion regularly with fixed anti-VEGF agents, that you can slow the development of retinal non-perfusion. So you can basically slow the disease process down. And that data is based on fluorescein angiographic data. And so our question was, well, can you ever get recovery of those non-perfused areas? And can anti-VEGF dosing impact that? So that's where we came up with the trial, recovery. It's a 2-year trial, it's open label, and it's randomized 1-to-1 to either monthly aflibercept or quarterly aflibercept with no loading doses. So in the first year, you either get 4 shots or you get 12 shots across a whole year. And we did all the clinical data was collected across Houston at multiple sites, and then all the imaging data was analyzed by Vasada and Mike Galip out in LA. So it was a collaboration looking at sort of the perfusion status in these eyes. Importantly, all these eyes had extensive non-perfusion at baseline without DME. So these were overall well-sighted eyes with proliferative diabetic retinopathy and extensive non-perfusion. Okay, so then what do the results show? Well, first of all, we saw what you would expect to see with the DRSS. So the diabetic retinopathy severity improved dramatically, right? You make the hemorrhages look a lot better, exactly. So at the beginning, all the patients were PDR. And at the end of 1 year, 50% of the eyes were level 43 or better. So moderate MPDR, dramatic improvement, just like you would expect from all the previous anti-VEGF data. And 40% of them were still characterized as PDR, mostly due to the presence of some residual fibrous tissue in the back of the eye. But then really the core of what we were interested in is, well, what's happening to these areas of perfusion? Because the primary outcome at 1 year was change in area of non-perfusion from baseline to 1 year. And so when we look at that, the importance was to compare the monthly with the quarterly dosed patients. And we actually wrote this trial thinking we would see quite a bit of reperfusion, because that was sort of the mantra at the time. There was a trial called Android that had just been reported multiple times by Jeff Heyer on Podium, showing large areas of reperfusion. And in reality, across both the monthly and the quarterly dose populations, we did not see population-wide large areas of reperfusion. The monthly dose patients showed stable retinal non-perfusion from baseline to 1 year, and the quarterly dose patients showed statistically significant progression or worsening of retinal non-perfusion by about 30% from baseline to 1 year. So you either get worse in the quarterly dosed arm or you stay about the same in the monthly dosed arm. That was the first of 2 take-homes from recovery. No widespread reperfusion, but there does appear to be a dose response where when you consistently dose these patients, you might be able to slow the progression of non-perfusion, very consistent with RIDE, RISE, and VISTA data that we had previously in the phase 3 trials. So the second major point is, when you look at a very granular level with these images, we did see changes in non-perfusion, mostly small regions of the fundus. And I already said the quarterly dose patients got worse on average, but in fact, both arms, more than half the patients actually had worsening of the retinal non-perfusion. And actually, in both populations, we did see small areas of reperfusion or recovery of areas of non-perfusion. And I'm still extremely skeptical about this concept of, can you truly have non-perfused retina that reperfuses? I think we have a lot to learn about this. I think it's dependent on the cardiac cycle and the level of other inflammatory factors in the back of the eye. There's issues like leukostatic plugging. So we have a lot to learn, but we did see vessels that were not present at baseline that we could visualize at 1 year. This was mostly noted in the mid-periphery with wide-field fluorescein angiography, but macula-based OCTA data showed the same thing, where on average we saw no change over time, but there were isolated vessels that did seem to fluctuate from baseline to 1 year, some getting worse, some getting better. So my overall takeaway from recovery is that the perfusion status in the back of the eye is a dynamic process, and certainly overall the trajectory for many eyes with diabetic retinopathy is worsening over time, but we appear to be able to slow that process with our pharmaceutical agents. And maybe in some eyes we can actually see recovery of areas of non-perfusion, although I think, at least in this series, those areas were small in a minority of eyes.